Each crew member on board has a special duty during emergencies. On the emergency plan, you will find information about your shipboard organisation during fire, the special duties for each crew member, and general fire instruction. The shipboard organisation on board are on most ships organised as follows. The shipboard organisation vary from ship to ship, so it is important that you become familiar with the organisation on board your vessel and that you know your duties during emergencies. Click on the different titles in the organisation chart and look at an example of the assignment for each squad. The master is in overall command and keeps in contact with all squads. The junior officer and the helmsman muster on bridge when the fire alarm sounds. The junior officer relieves the duty officer and operates GMDSS radio as per the master's instruction. The chief officer is in charge of the operation if the fire is on deck or in the accommodation. The chief officer reports to the master as soon as he arrives on the scene. The chief engineer is in charge of the operation if the fire is in the machinery space. The chief engineer reports to the master as soon as he arrives on the scene. He is also in charge of releasing CO2 or halon on orders from the master. Muster at their muster station as instructed. Collect relevant equipment and put on gear as required for the particular emergency. Report to bridge when ready. When ordered, place necessary equipment close to the emergency site. Muster at their muster station as instructed. Collect relevant equipment and put on gear as required for the particular emergency. Report to bridge when ready. When ordered, place necessary equipment close to the emergency site. Muster in the engine control room. If not accessible, meet at the fire control station. Report to bridge when ready. Start fire pumps or other machinery as requested. At the sound of the halon alarm or CO2, leave the engine room at once and report to the person in charge. Muster at their muster station as instructed. Report to bridge when ready. If required or ordered, stop requested ventilation and close fire flaps. Isolate electrical equipment. Operate fire, emergency, technical appliances. Start emergency fire pump. Muster at the ship's hospital. Report to bridge when ready. As ordered, collect stretcher and first aid kit and proceed to the place of incident. Transport respiration. Search cabins if anybody missing. Constant vigilance or watchfulness is important on board ships and on offshore installations. All crew should be aware of the risk of fire, proper behaviour on board, and every individual's responsibility. Even though ships are constructed to be as safe as possible, there is still the risk that accidents may occur. This is because many ships carry oil, gas, or chemicals on board. In addition, a great deal of dangerous work such as welding, burning and grinding take place on board. It is therefore important to follow procedures for dangerous work such as hot work and cold work, fire watch, fire rounds on board. Click on the buttons to learn more. Hot work is any work involving welding or burning, and other work such as grinding and electrical. Hot work outside the engine room workshop should be prohibited until safety considerations have been met, and hot work permits have been issued. When hot work is performed, remember to check the surrounding area for combustible gases. Always have a fire extinguisher close by. Always have a fire watch posted. There should always be a person on fire watch when hot work is being performed. The designated fire watch should never have any other duties than being a fire watch. It is essential that all crew on board have the right attitude towards the prevention of fire. The company should therefore ensure that safety awareness is an important factor in their quality management. All crew should be aware of irregularities. Report irregularities. Follow instructions, orders, and company procedures. Have a good understanding of the contingency plan. Keep the workplace clear and tidy. You are responsible for your own safety. It is therefore of vital importance that you know your duties when accidents occur and that you show safety consciousness. Safety is, among other factors, well-planned work operations, trained co-workers, training and drills, good working environment, good working methods and procedures, correct use of tools. What shall you do if you detect a fire? Please read the general fire instructions below. Activate alarm signal on detection of fires, no matter how small the fire seems to be. Try to extinguish a starting fire with extinguishers, blankets, etc. If it's not possible to put out the fire during its first few minutes, close all ventilation to prevent air reaching the place of fire. Do not open doors or hatches from areas where smoke is not seen to be coming out, unless wearing fire protection equipment and carrying fire extinguishing equipment. Keep in mind that a smouldering fire may produce invisible toxic gas. On alarm, it is important that everybody musters as quickly as possible in order to see if anybody is missing. Report immediately if any person is missing. If the ship is in port, call the local fire authority immediately. It is the duty of every member of the ship's personnel to be familiar with the location of all equipment, hand extinguishers, hoses, and emergency exits.